Hello, I'm MrSorbias, and today we are going to review the Flip Fluids Blender add-on. Flip Fluids is one of the most famous Blender add-ons out there. I bet most of you have at least heard of it before. It's been working progress something like, I think, at least 2 years, and the creator is still working with it, which I think is really cool. The add-on marketplace is promising a lot, and I'm really excited to see what I can do with it. So let's go to Blender to see what we can do. Just like always, installing add-ons is really easy, and Flip Fluids is not an exception with this pattern. Just go to User Preferences and Add-ons and search the add-on file you downloaded and double-click it, and here you have it. Just check this checkbox and save user settings and you are ready to go. The add-on creates here to the left this Flip Fluids panel, but the panel is missing, for example, the domain button. So you are anyways forced to use also the physics settings to be able to create something with this add-on. At least it's the case on this version of Flip Fluids. So the settings are here on the physics panel. When I have this cube selected, I can activate the Flip Fluids add-on and select what we wanna make out from this object. I will make it to be a domain. The domain object always has to be cuboid. You can scale your cube in any way you like to, but do not distort it because it will not work. Now let's create the fluid object. It will be another cube and I will just scale it until I find it good. Everything that is outside of the domain object will be removed from the simulation. So it's a good idea to have a little bit bigger fluid object to make sure that it's as big as possible inside of the domain. Let's keep the fluid cube selected and from Flip Fluid settings make it to be a fluid object. The next thing I wanna do is a big bubble of liquid that is going to fall to the bigger pool of liquid. Okay, let's test how this simulation will work. So I select the domain object and go to the settings and click bake. That's easy. With these default settings and quite low body fluid, it's doing the baking quite fast. I was actually surprised how fast it is. It's so fast that I think the best process to work with this add-on is to make lots of test bakes to see how the fluid is going, and then edit settings and do another bake and so on. So I just clicked reset to stop the baking and now I'm going to add another object here. The plan is to add just a random physics object here and drop it to the pool and see what's going to happen. I feel like a kid who is throwing stones to the lake. Now from the physics tab I make the object to be an active element. And then I just bake the rigid body simulation to make sure that I will not get any surprises later. Next step is to make the baked physics object to be Flip Fluids object. If the object is animated, then we also should check the export animated mesh checkbox. Now we need to select the domain again and click the bake button again to make the simulation. It's really cool that we can still use Blender and edit the scene even when the Flip Fluids is baking. After a few minutes the simulation is baked enough so that I can start playing it even when it's still baking. Looks really cool, not very original though. The playback speed is very low, only 9 frames per second. The more details you have in your simulation, the slower it will be playing. Let's do something a little bit more complex. I wanna create a glass of some sort of fizzy drink. Let's see what's going to happen. I will speed up the settings I made earlier so this video don't repeat itself too much. now I have the object here which I'm going to use as a container for the fluid, the glass. Next thing is to add an object that is going to be an inflow object, a place from where the fluid will come to the scene. I will use an icosphere for that. I just need to make it as an inflow object from the flip fluid settings, and then I will adjust the direction to where the fluid flow is going. Then I can make my very first test bake. I forgot something very important in this simulation. I wanted to animate the inflow icosphere to stop flowing new fluid to the scene after some specific frame. You only need to animate one checkbox in flip fluid's inflow settings, and it's very easy. Now, without doing it, this simulation is going to add new fluid to the scene forever. Cheap lemonade. The second problem I have in this scene is that the glass is too thin. Sometimes the simulation is allowing the fluid go through the glass surface, and that really is not what we wanna do. So we should model something much more thicker and then create the finished thin glass layer later to prevent any fluid leaks. Anyways, one weak fix I made because of that problem is this outflow object cube. It will remove all fluid that is leaking out from the glass. It didn't work as nicely as I was hoping. After baking the high resolution fluid simulation, we can see that tiny fluid pattern which doesn't look realistic at all. It happens because of the fluid particles are too small, and together with the domain resolution, it will create this strange pattern. So, if I make the fluid particles little bigger, it will remove the pattern. As you can see, now with little bigger particles, the pattern is gone. Because the playback is little laggy, I will activate the preview resolution for viewport and use the high resolution only for render. Let's talk a little bit about the fluid presets. We have here a very good collection of fluid presets which we can use on our scenes, and all the settings are pre-made for us. But the sad thing is that those thumbnails are lying to us. We are not able to create that nice foam as we can see, for example, on the beer or coffee preset thumbnail. So I dare to say that these presets are not made with this add-on. I started with the beer preset, and then I made some slight edits to the settings and materials to maximize the amount of foam and bubbles. The add-on is able to bake the scenes very fast, but for some reason the rendering process was really painful. With GPU I was not able to render at all. That's not a surprise because it's highly dense mesh with much of polygons. But the big surprise was that also with the CPU I had lots of problems. Basically what it meant to me, I was able to render about 5 to 20 frames and then Blender crashed. So when the finished animation is over 200 frames, it means that I cannot leave my home. I was stuck here to start Blender all the time again to keep the process going. During the render, I read two historical novels. Before I show you the finished render I made, I'll show you what the real foam looks like, so you can compare it to the render. As you can see, we cannot do this with the add-on. In real foam, the bubbles are able to grow, etc. So I really wish the add-on maker will continue working with this bubble simulator side of this add-on. It's really good already, but not enough. I know him as a skilled programmer, so I bet he can also simulate the bubbles better than what it is at the moment. The other scene I made with this add-on is this bubble of liquid in zero gravity. Then I have animated bullet to fly through the water. The foam material is made with an emission shader, so it's a little bit more visible here than in my glass scene. I think now would be the time to make some sort of conclusion about this add-on. For this video, I didn't test all the features of this add-on because the add-on is very huge and I believe it's expensive because of it really is also good. Not perfect though. Instead, I tried to test only the features which I believe would be challenging to do with this add-on. That's why I was focusing so much on the foam and bubbles. So I will collect all the pros and cons I was able to figure out in a list so you can yourself check if this add-on is something you wanna use. Number 1. For me, it was a huge problem to render anything out from this add-on even with CPU in cycles because Blender was crashing all the time when rendering. It renders few frames and then crashes, so I need to be watching whole process and starting Blender again to keep the rendering going. I don't know what would cause this problem, but it really was annoying, and if it's going to stay like this, it definitely will reduce the usability of this add-on. Number 2. I also was not able to select some of the add-on presets. When trying to select copper, it will select coffee. Number 3. There is no way to add random sized bubbles or real foam simulation where the bubbles act naturally. That will reduce the realism of the simulations quite much, and I really wish those will be added. Number 4. No support for force field objects. But I've heard that the developer is working to add the support for those later, so I will be very happy when those are available. There is also so many good sides on this add-on, so I will collect some of them which I found very interesting. Number 1. There is no upper limit for viscosity setting, so you can simulate also solid objects or metals with flip fluids. That's creativity freedom. Number 2. Presets are really nice and you can create your own fluid presets. Number 3. Flip fluids is baking really fast and that makes working with it very funny and you can do lots of test bakes and see how the scene reacts your modelings. Number 4. The add-on also works with fracture modifier, but I have not tested it yet. I have only seen some really nice and cool looking videos about this. For flip fluids, I will give 4 stars. It's really great add-on and I think I'm going to do many nice simulations with it in future. I know the price is quite salty for hobbyist, but there literally is no other way to do this task in Blender at this moment. I say at this moment because at future we might have. There is also coming a Manta Flow for Blender from the same creators, so I don't know will it replace or need to use flip fluids later, but meanwhile when we don't have an official Manta Flow Blender, I recommend flip fluids. Also, I recommend it because it's simply great and I hope that the developer will keep working with Blender.